Welcome back. The Kawhi Leonard situation continues to get uglier and uglier by the day. And now we have this bombshell that has been dropped on us. There was a point during Kawhi's rehab process, this was in New York, that some of the Spurs brass went out to see him. As soon as those guys arrived to the building, Kawhi's people grabbed him and sequestered him to another part of the building. And so the Spurs couldn't even see him. And then it gets even weirder, where he screwed his agency in order to get his uncle and many other family members paid. I know it's tough to see, but this is his agency, ISB, placing his uncle and mother on the payroll for at least the last 5 years. We have seen this so many times, and I completely understand that players want to take care of their family, but he did it in order to screw his agency and for them to get paid. One Reddit user pointed out, Brian Elfis had been the agent of Kawhi, partner to Frank Mitchell of Impact Sports. Elfis alleges an agreement between him and Frankel required the consultation of large expenses to be had between both parties, but that was not done for the payroll expense of Kawhi's family. Again, I completely understand that these guys want to take care of their family, but I think there's a way to do it. And also, just this whole Kawhi Leonard episode, I'm ready for it to be over.
I think I'm missing out.
Yeah, I'm so ready. Like, Lakers, Clippers, Spurs, nope, screw Greg Popovich. Maybe I want to do this, but possibly want to do that. I'm in recovery, but wait, I'm not rehabbing. But wait, I got to play, but wait, I'm not going to play.
It's
Both parties at this point. I can't lay blame on Popovich. I can't lay blame on Kawhi.
I have a third party. But go ahead. How do we keep hearing about it? Like, if we don't stop following.
I love how JR's like, I have this huge idea, but you go first.
No, I'm going to say, she started talking before I did. But I mean, if you're going to follow the man around everywhere it goes and find out all these weird, intricate details and tell us about it, don't be complaining when we have to read about it. Be like, I can't believe we keep hearing, not that you're saying, not you, but
I'm
like,
not. I'm just ready
oh, I'm sorry, but Kawhi Leonard. Why do we keep hearing about him? I'm writing an article right now about Kawhi Leonard. Well, you're telling us.
Well, I want to know. Him. He's a premier player in the league.
I care. I'm not tired of
Finals MVP.
Yeah.
I think he's a top five player regardless. And one of what's most frustrating is that, yes, we still have not heard from him. But at the same time, we don't take into account that he's still getting all this backlash. Could you imagine just how difficult it is for him? You know, he knows that he's a great player. He knows mm-hmm. the type of talent that he's able to deliver. And yet he's still getting all this backlash and has yet to say anything. That's so frustrating. It takes so yeah. much self-control on his behalf. So I applaud him for not feeding on to all the negativity
that he... That's just him, like, not wanting to say anything. He's a mute.
He is a mute, but how much more are we
going to push it? But then again, actions speak louder than words, right, guys?
Well, yeah. I just can't wait to see him play again and see if he's healthy. That's the hard part, because no one knows. And it's prerogative to keep it a secret.
It is us filling in the blanks. That's it. That's all I'm doing. Mm-hmm. Is when I know a player's personality mm-hmm. as it relates to the media, I know how to fill the blanks
right.
in. But with Kawhi, he hasn't played,
right.
he hasn't
right.
talked. I don't know what to do with him.
But like,
and I know he's a great player.
Right.
But the longer this drags out, the more, I mean, part of this is about how the person financing one of the teams is a Trump supporter and how that right. factors in.
Well, we wait and see what exactly is going to happen with Kawhi Leonard.